Okay, welcome back to another stream. In this stream, I'm gonna maybe try to start looking into some scripts in Python. Right now, only one script, and that's gonna be to try to get the log that's written from Jenkins that gives us any error messages or build success, anything like that. I believe it's under program files. Or it might be program files 86, Jenkins, jobs, these, and pretty much this log file. I don't know what this changelog.xml is. No, doesn't say anything. But this log, I want to open it with Sublime Text. It's this. I pretty much want to. I don't know if I want to copy this entire thing. Maybe I will just to have it. But this is pretty much what we want to copy and put into its own thing. So, what we gotta do a couple things. Like honestly, I've written Python before, but it has been a long time, so I don't know exactly potentially the right syntax. So I gotta do some research on this Python Slack Python library. Okay, Slack API. CMD. Can I just type in Python? Okay, so that we're in the right directory. So Python, I gotta remember the syntax again. How to install Python libraries, I guess. Because from CMD, you can definitely do it. Da 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 da. Pip, yeah, okay. Okay, pip install, and then it was what? Slack Python install CMD, maybe? Okay, so it says. Pip install Slack client. No? Python pip install Slack client. What's wrong with this? Pip install. No. Okay. I think it maybe that's just wrong. CMD pip install Slack cli. Okay. Okay, might as well upgrade the pip installation. Python m py, pip no Python dash m pip install upgrade pip. Okay. Okay, so we got everything there. Okay, so we should have this client now. Using Python, because I don't want to. I want to use Visual Studio for this. Using Python in Visual Studio. So prerequisites. Okay, create a new Python project. That's what I'm doing. That's what I have. Takes me a moment. So okay. Next step, write and run code. Okay. Okay, so they have import in addition to completions for state social intelligence part. Okay. So I guess we could just do the print command, right? Hello. And that should be enough, right? Yeah, hello. Okay. So we're good. I think I need system for this script. Import sys. Import. Do I have Slack? Jenkins? No. Okay, let me look at the. No, wrong screen. Okay, let me just try Slack message script in Python. Yes, this can be done instead of okay. There's this. Okay. Simple solution is using Slack's web API. Okay, let me get my Slack token. Okay, that's my Slack. Okay, I don't want to do that. Do I just have to do it like that? Is it a string or whatever that's called? Yes. So data. Token, okay, so channel. I need a request, import requests. I'll just okay, so channel. Let's just do a step by step. So channel. Build notifications, right? View channel details. User ID you can get here. So, Python Slack web API. So that's this, right? Basic usage of the web cloud. So import OS and import Slack. Okay, I'm gonna do this. Okay, let's see. Import OS. Import Slack. No. Okay. Well, no. How can I? Do I have to import any libraries? Let's see. Import Python library in Visual Studio. See. Okay, let's see. Pip install, whatever. Python. Okay. Okay. No, I don't need Team Explorer. Oh God. How did you open that? I have really bad memory. Okay, hold on. How do I do it? Tools. Python. Python environments. Okay, then what? Okay, so there should be an overview. Packages. Where was the text that he wrote earlier? Pip? Slack? Which one do I want? Python Slack client. So install Slack client. This is the one I need. Okay. Okay. Now import. No, I already have the word import. Let's see. Import. That it? No. Slack. Okay. No. Why? So it literally is there, right? Import Slack. Import Slack. So I have it right here. So Slack client. I can't. Oh my God. And then Slack dot anything? No completions. Why? So manage my Python packages. Okay. So overview packages. Guess there's more stuff for it. Let's see. Send, okay, well, read the tutorial to get started. So I got Python. Okay. Building a message. Python, how to import Slack client. Installation. So like I did not mean to open that. Close, please. Slack dot web client. I mean, let me just do this. Press any key to continue. Okay. I will move this to the other monitor. Let's see. Let's see. What is so hashtag build dash notifications. Text hello world, sir. Upload, okay. Let's see. Let's see. Okay. Token equals, let me get my Slack token again. Do Slack token. Okay. Okay, so that worked. Cool. Okay. Okay. Let me see. So, uploading files to Slack. Let's see. How do I do want to set this up? So let me just make channel its own variable. Equals Slack channel text. Let's see. How do I want this to work? Let's see. Python main function. Because I definitely want to have an argument, right? Okay, let me define main. Make that all part of main, right? Okay, and then at the bottom of main, there's the thing, right? There, yeah, if. Name, yeah, equals main. Main. So that should still work, right? Yes. Okay. Yeah, Slack chat. So, okay. What should I do? Let's see if I can get it to upload. So, uploading files. So literally it's file, right? Okay. Let me define some functions here. Def send file, and then def send message. So those are fine. Let's see. Let me just do, this is the message. Yeah, okay. And can I just do a return? Okay. So this is to send a file. So channel is going to be Slack channel. I don't need S here. So file, okay. I think we need the entire directory. So, send file. Okay. So can I just now call send file? Let's see. Name send files not defined. So do I have to move that up? Is it the same way with the C++ where they have to be defined first? Client is not defined. Okay. So client channel. Client Slack channel. Slack channel is not defined. Yeah, channel. Line what? Oh, do I have to include log? Log. Let's see. No. R? Okay. So it didn't fail, but it didn't work. Okay, client channel. Let's send a message though. Yes, that's a hashtag. Okay. Send message. Let's add another parameter. Message. So we got client, Slack, channel, and then I don't know. Function test. Place that here. Send message. Oh, yeah, I gotta move it up. Okay. Okay, function test. Okay. Assertion error. I don't know if I need that. Okay. We changed the rest of our list. Token content file. So everything is optional. Okay. Python script that. Upload file to Slack channel. How to upload files? Okay. Let's see. Slack token client. All right. How old is this answer, though? So, client.files underscore upload. File equals okay, let's do a text document. Slack test. Let's open it. Blah. Okay. Can I literally just do like t desktop slash slack test dot txt? Okay, I don't want to send a message, send a file. Okay, directory, no. Do I have to use that? And just, do I still have to do R? Okay, well, why did it do that? No such file and directory. Okay. It's fine. It's fine. Get out of there. Properties, details. Can I get a copy of that? Okay, I'll have to keep it open. Do do do. So it's C users Devon desktop. Let's try that. Okay. So that worked. But that takes a while. Let me do it again. Okay, so that's quick. Okay. So it's sending that. Okay. Let's see. I want to get some arguments here. Like main argument Python, main arguments, yeah, command line arguments. Okay, what do I want my main line arguments to be? Python. I can't believe I forgot what they're called again. Command line arguments. Let's see. It's not what I wanted. Python, how to use command line arguments. Stack bin. Okay, let's see. That did not help. Nothing is helping me. Like, I know there was, I remember there was documentation on this Python command line arguments. Give me something good. Okay, this one says it's an easy guide. Guess I gotta import arg parse. Import arg parse. Let's see. Okay. Let's just follow this parser. Let me just copy this. So parser argument parser description. Argument parser for Python script. Add argument. File directory. I'll do lowercase. File directory. Default. Which, yeah, default should just be empty. Help us. Okay. This is the variable that holds the directory of the log file we want to upload. Where was it? Program 86, Jenkins, Joms, builds. What are the properties for this? Can I expand this window at all? No. I guess I could just do build number. Default can be 0. This is the variable that holds the build number to use in our directory. Okay. Guess that might need to be moved in here. Okay. Let's see. Args equals parser dot parse args. Okay, and then build number equals args dot build number. I don't know if that's right, but Let's try. So it was under our depot, build scripts, Python, Jenkins Slack messaging, and then okay, CMD, Python, Jenkins, Slack message dot py. Okay, now we just can just do run, right? Let's just try it. Run Jenkins Slack message 50. Okay. No. Dot py. Okay, Python Jenkins Slack message dot py 50. No module. Python give arguments in Visual Studio. Let's see. Okay. So it says to right click on your project. Choose properties. Okay, there's no debug tab. No, in the Solution Explorer. Whoops. Window? No. So where's the Solution Explorer? No, I don't want to. That's not what I wanted. Okay. So there's debug. Script arguments 50. Okay. Let's look at that again. Project debug 50. Error, unrecognized arguments. 50. Where is that build number, like big build number showing up? Do I have to add type? Usage. Unrecognized arguments 50. Do I have to hi? Why is it saying unrecognized documents? Okay. Error unrecognized argument Python. Yeah, tutorial. Okay. Does that have to be like that? Okay. Good. We fixed that. Print our, we can do build number, right? Build number. So it should just say hi, right? Yes. Okay. Does it have to be in parentheses? Can I literally just put 50? Yeah, okay. Okay, CMD. Python. I gotta figure out this error too. Python, Jenkins, Slack, message, .py. And then 50. Yeah. Why? Why can it not find it? Let's see. Module Python module not found. When running in CMD. Okay. Okay, so there is a solution. So Python M Jenkins message dot so still wrong. Python. Still wrong. PyCache. So that doesn't help me. No. I'm trying to run a script that launches. I get it. No, module found. The solution is to write the path to your module. Slack client. Tools. Python. Yeah, it's Slack client. Okay, let's see. Is it under programs? Python. Include? No. Library. Let's see, program files, is it under here? Microsoft Visual Studio 2019 community. Python? Does it have anything for Python? This is tough. Pa pa pa. I don't know. God damn. Program 86. No, yeah. 2019 community common packages. I don't want to look it up on Internet Explorer. Why would you do that? No, don't close out. Let's see. Depot, build scripts, Python. Edit with idle. Does it work with idle? Run module. So that works. But why doesn't it work from CMD? Okay, so, guess that technically works, but let me open up the solution. I want to be able to upload that log file. Okay, so it's let me delete these messages. Delete. Okay, why? Let's see. Okay, let's try it again. So, program files, Jenkins, jobs, builds. So we want to call, directory equals, let me also stop printing and sending files real quick. So directory equals R, like that, right? And then that, print directory. Let's just make sure the directory is printing right. Why? Is that not what? Unexpected token. Is that? Why is that wrong? Okay. So, why is that wrong? Okay, so that's right. How do we append? Let's see, Python append string. Let's see. Is it literally just plus? Plus. Can I just do like direct? Plus equals hi. Yeah. Okay. Let's move this down here. Okay. Directory. Oops. Okay, no, that doesn't work. So we'll have to plus, plus build number. Okay, why can't I get that? Python error when using in string. Let's see. Okay. No. Does that cause a problem? Can 9 do this? Okay, so that's still a problem, okay. Python build directory string, maybe? Create path finally from string in Python, okay. No. So, I guess I can use backslashes. Guess that's not a big deal. Whoops. Plus build number. Okay. Is there a way to check Python check if directory exists? Okay. There it does. OS.path.exists. Okay. OS.path.exists. So it's expecting a string, so directory, right? And it should say true. So no. Ah, because it literally does not. Okay, debug. No. Project. Let's change this to 56. Now it should say true. Yes. Check if file, Python, check if file exists in a directory. Okay. Check if file exists. Okay. I guess we should have a bunch of checks. So, okay. First we'll check directory. So, os.path.exists. So I want to do it this way. So if directory do I need a colon? Yeah. Print path exists, and then we want to do I guess file equals open. So directory slash log. Except IO error. That's a thing, okay. Print file. Does it exist, I guess, or not accessible? Finally, file.close. So pat six, okay, so it's saying, okay. What is it? Project. So 56. Log. What is the file type of of log files? A file with the log. Why does file not have extension? Yeah, I guess. How to open a file with an extension? Log dot log? I don't know. So file does not exist. Does it have, okay, change log dot XML. Let's just see if it does this. So that's not even accessible. Try okay. With open as file. Print file dot read lines. Print. Indentation error. Okay. Oops. I don't know if this is right. Looks right. Oops. Du-du-du-du-du. Let's see. Built-in method relines of. Let me just add log dot txt. Let's see. What does this mean? Let's see. I am writing from it. Okay. Like that. Okay, so that printed correctly. Okay, so that gives me the. Okay, let's change this to 54. Okay, so it definitely is now giving me information. Let's see. Let's see. Let's type in message equals file dot read lines. Now, finally, we'll send a message. Message. Okay, this has a message. Looks kind of gross. Okay. Try, let's see if we can send the file now. It sending more than one message? Yeah, it's doing a bunch of messages. Oh. Oh my. Okay, delete Delete. Delete all of it. Okay. Send file. I gotta remember how to do that. So I'm able to read the contents. So file. So client and then directory, right? So send file. Stop giving me all that. Is that right? Okay, so that's correct, but we didn't do this correctly. So file equals directory. Yes. Okay. Great. Where's that noise coming from? The file doesn't have an app associated with it. Okay. What else do we gotta figure out? Hold on. I gotta fix my pants. Ugh. Okay. Let's see. Okay, we got a lot working. We still don't know if this will work when we put it into the post-build scripts. Python change name of file uploaded to Slack, because I want to change files the upload method. So there's one called file name. Okay. File name equals build logs.txt. Let's see. Slack. Let's delete messages. Tuple indices must be integers or slices, not string. Oh, stop it. Will that work? Definitely not. No. I need to add a comma. Tuple. File name of file. Tuple indices. Let's see. Um, So file. So file channel, so file name. I don't know. Oh yeah, I'd like to do it from. Da 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 da. Okay. Does that still work? Just take this out. Slack client. Okay. Slack bot token. Edit configuration? What? Is there like an edit configuration? No. Let me look. Depot build scripts. Yeah, post the Slack. Where's this thing? Does that do anything? I don't want to do it. No, stop doing that. client equals Slack dot web client token equals that. I gotta put then strings. Let's send a message. Okay, so that didn't work. Do I have to do this entire thing? No. Can I just that's still probably gonna be no, right? Okay, so that's not gonna work. Let's just do one thing at a time, right? How do I change the name of the file? Okay, this information is like old. Slack upload give custom file name. No. Let me just check equals client dot files dot upload. That doesn't give me anything. So tuple built in if it client dot file upload Slack. Okay. So there's channels, so file try adding the file name, file type. No. Type text equals build log from Jenkins. Does that do anything? Okay. Ah, God. I did not mean to do that. So, oh, God. Delete, delete, delete. I gotta delete a lot. Okay. I messed up. Messed up real bad, boys. Delete. Okay. I do not want to send a message. I want to send a file. Oh, do I have to send a message first? Oh, that's probably what that is. Okay, build log from Jenkins. Okay. Slack channel is not defined. Build log from Jenkins. Okay. Okay. Okay, so we kind of got it, what I wanted to do. Its name is file, but I don't want it to be called file. Yeah, I know. It's file. I doubt it's going to work, but let's try it from Jenkins. What's it? Localhost 880. Do-do-do. Okay. Main repo. Configure. Okay. Add build step. Okay. Need to let's see. Add arguments to dot bat. Okay, let me make a dot bat file, right? So Python. Let's add it here. New text document, whatever. Upload build log. Dot that. Yes. Okay. And what do we want to do? We have to open up this directory, right? And then slash Jenkins slack message dot py. And then so we want to do P4 change list in here somewhere. Let's see. So maybe a percentage sign? Python scripts. Let's see if this even works. Python scripts, upload build log dot bat, and then 53. No. Okay. Upload build log. Save, configure. Okay. See. Build with parameters. Yeah. Okay. Let's see if this works. Because it would tell us build success. Okay. I really hope this works. Fingers crossed, fingers crossed, fingers crossed. Okay. It's zipping. Now there should already be Jenkins jobs builds and a 57 and the log. This is the longest part, I guess. Maybe I should switch the order. Let's just see what happens. Whether it works or not, it's whatever. Okay. Okay, so depot. Was that our depot or where was it? So it was builds, right? Euro. Build archives? No. Where are these uploaded to? So hero builds. So depot, hero builds. Development. So 14. Ah. Is there a way to get the job number? Damn it. It's not the P4 change list. I'm so stupid. There should be environment variables, right? See list environment variables. Change ID. Build number. Apply. Save. Build with parameters now. Build. Let's see. One more time. I promise. One more time. Da, da, da. Sorry, I'm kind of not paying attention. Let's just see if this works. I hope it works. Because if it works, then I kind of want to clean up this script. This is kind of messy. But I also want to post a message. Like of the error. That's why I would have to see. Okay, I don't need this open. So it's zipping. I also set my alarm for tomorrow. I gotta go to work. Let's do. We'll do 7:15 a.m. So it took 3 minutes before. And this job, I don't know when it started. At 7:45. So it was a success. What the hell is the Why? I was pretty sure that was gonna work. Let's see. I'm very upset. We were close. CMD. Upload, build. Wow. Okay. Upload. Build log. That bat. 57. So that works, right? Let's try that again. CDE? No, I could just do this, right? E slash depot slash build dash script slash upload build log dot bat and 57, right? That should work. E. Oh. Duh. Depot slash build script slash upload build log dot bat 57. So this just tells me. That build number isn't anything. But it should be. The current build number, such as, is it in quotes? Like literally build number, but so this gives me everything. I know that's the P4 change list one. Do I have to do call? Let's try it. Ugh, I keep saying one more build, but this makes me upset. 'Cause like it works, right? Like I'm not that crazy. Maybe I am just that crazy. This their time is the charm. I doubt it's gonna work though. But I don't know what the difference between just literally that command line function and using the word call. I give me repo configure. What are the other? It's this call. Oh, that's not going to work. Definitely not. Success. I want to do it again. But I do want to make this a post build action. But it says enter path to file directory here. Do that, but let's also do this. I swear to God, that is. I don't know if it's gonna work. Doesn't hurt to try, I guess. Jobs, builds. So it's literally. Build number. Slash log, apply. Build, build. This is it. I swear. And then I'll just move on with my life. I'm going to keep trying to get this to work, though. I think this is very important to have to work. I want to have things automated. I want to be able to build these. I want it to tell me on Slack what's wrong. And so on and so forth. So we'll try it again. This is the last time, I swear. Build successful. Okay. I hope this works. but, you know, just because it's me, it's probably not going to work. That's showbiz, baby, but, you know, it is what it is. So once it's done zipping, it tells us if it's good. Okay, so it failed. So, okay, I gotta fix that some other day. Just for my own sake, I just want to know if that will work. Just putting a straight up number in there. If it's going to be 59, and we know that exists because we just did it, this is the last one. I just want to know if that much works. I don't know if I even just did that, but I does build number not work? Like, why would build number, like, what does it give you? Like, it should be fine as a string. Oh well. This will be the last attempt for this stream. But we did write a good amount. Needs to be cleaned up. Probably a lot of unnecessary shit here. Do. Yeah, that works. Where could it possibly go wrong? So it fails here. Because I see print build number. Okay, I know I lied ag again. But I gotta know what it's gonna print build number. Apply, save. Build. Sorry for all the notifications, just testing some Jenkins stuff. Okay. And I know it'll print something because we saw it say path exists when it did the last one. So. This one, I promise, it's gonna be the last one. Because I think we've been streaming for 2 hours now. Yeah. 2 hours to get nothing done sounds right to me. Whatever, that's how it goes. At least we're learning something. Well, I don't know. I don't even know if I am learning anything. But whatever. How many builds does it keep? I think it was like 30, right? Let's see. Deep bow. Hero. Builds. Development. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Since it's the same one, it's just overriding it, so we're good. I don't think we need that one. A temp. Oh, yeah, let's just gonna write temp right there. Bup, bup, bup. Okay. So it's literally passing in build number. Why? I don't know. Let's see. Do I have to use these? I don't care. I'm doing another one. I'm such a liar. Console output. I hope this is right. Okay. This takes so much. Even though it takes like 3 minutes, it feels like an eternity. Excuse me, I'm really tired. Okay, it's zipping. Fingers crossed. Oh, yeah. Oh. Fuck yeah. Watch the language. Sorry. Okay. Automatically did it. Boom. Now I want to be able to. Oops. So here's the file. Sublime. This is it, right? 63. Yeah. Great. We did it. Hooray. I would like it to be a post-build action, though. I don't. I'm not sure how to, though. Because there's execute Windows Bash command. There doesn't seem to be one. Oh, that has to be prefixed. This needs that. I wonder. Okay. I lied again. I want to do it one more time. One more time. I just want to see if those changes that I just made for the post to Slack notifications works. Because if it does work, then I wasted time making a Python script. But I might want to write a Python script that checks for errors and posts the error as a message. Because that would be interesting and nice. This is the last. Because we know it works now. At least the script that we made. So that's good. Definitely want to take another stream to clean it up. See if there's anything we could do better. Probably there is. And then, if this works with the post notifications, post build action, then I might want to remake the script that will just paste the error as a message, just so we get the full build. And we get the full log file, and we get a message that just says, the error message. So I'll be the goal for the next time. Let's just let this thing do its thing, and then, we'll go from there. Should almost be done zipping now. Okay, so it still didn't work. But we have our version, which is fine. Not a big deal. Just want to look at this for 1 second. So hash build notifications. Hash channel. Token. Enter path to file. Enter the directory path of the files you want. Let's do it. All right. I suck. I know. Let me just do this. So there's C, users, Devin, desktop. I just want to see if it'll upload a file correctly. Slack test. Apply. Save. Build. Oh, no, no. Build with parameters. Build. One more time. I'm addicted to it. Let's go to, I gotta stop biting my lips too. Just as a personal aside. Sorry, that was Jurassic Park. I hope I don't get demonetized. Actually, I can't even be monetized. There's not enough people watching, but that's fine. I'm not sad at all about it. But maybe I'll do a tutorial, like, once I can clean up the script a little bit, maybe I can make a tutorial about this Python script. Maybe that can help other people. But also at the same time, let's see if this post upload, whatever that file upload to Slack plugin will work for this test. Because if it does, I don't know what I would want to do. Okay, it's zipping it. I'm still zipping it. Okay. Okay, yes. Didn't upload. So it didn't, that plugin, I don't know why it doesn't work, but our script does. So good enough for now. I want to be able to try to change the name of this file and the extension if possible. It's fine that it's coming from me. And I would also want to post the error message, so I would definitely need to do some more with this. But I think that's it for now. Definitely, I'm done. No more. So thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm glad we got something remotely close to done. We gotta clean this up for sure. But after we get this working, I think I want to try to get my Perforce server, not Perforce, my, what is it, localhost 8081. What's the, my database for Jira. I want to be able to host an actual website so people can actually use it, besides me. So maybe by the end of this month, I don't know. But once that's done, once I feel good about that, then we can actually start this project and actually start working in Unreal. So we're getting close. I know this stuff may not be very interesting to a lot of people, but it's something I wanted to learn, and I'm glad I'm doing it. So thanks for sticking with me. Make sure to subscribe if you haven't already, like the video, comment any questions or concerns, or just join our Discord server. Our Discord server has a couple people. It's not super populated, but, you know, I always tell you when I'm streaming. We have all these different channels, stuff like that. So definitely join, and, you know, you can communicate with me directly. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you on the next stream. Bye.